This is the project Smart Agriculture, and in this project we are trying to make the agriculture a bit more smart. So when I went through some farms and gardens, I discovered that there were three main problems. The plants were not timely or properly watered, and sometimes there was overwatering, which causes a lot of water wastage across the globe. Many plants were also affected by some unidentified diseases, which cause great damage to the plant. In India, many people own their lands and villages, but they live in cities and are not present to look after it. So here's how I try to solve the three main problems. So I designed a system that can that comprises of central server and some nodes. So this is the central server, and the server is being run by the Raspberry Pi. So there are many nodes, and so those nodes are connected via Wi-Fi currently on the Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi is running the Node-RED server, which compiles all the data and send it to the cloud. Here I have used the Blink service so that we can view it on our smartphone. So now for the image recognition. So I am using the Raspberry Pi also to detect some detect the plant diseases. So here we have the camera, and this is the plant. So it can detect the like the diseases like chlorosis based on some of the symptoms, like say yellowing of the edges of the leaves. So these diseases are identified with the help of machine learning and TensorFlow. So after it identifies it and it finds that there is a disease, then it will take the picture and send it to your email. So here, since it is a good little leaf, then it will not detect the diseases. So now comes the part of detecting the taking the monitoring of the farm. So I designed this robot that can move automatically with the help of GPS, and it comprises of a Wi-Fi module with two sensors, a BME-280 and a gas sensor. So this sensor can detect soil temperature, moisture and humidity, and then this sensor can detect all the different types of gases. So all this data is being sent to this node MCU. It's a Wi-Fi microcontroller, and then that is connected to the Raspberry Pi over Wi-Fi, and it then compiles all the data, and that also from the nodes, and then pumps it on the cloud. For the nodes part, I have this little circuit. So it is not made waterproof, so I have this bags, and so it has a soil moisture sensor down, and then we have a soil temperature sensor. So this is the soil temperature sensor, DS18B20. It's a quite accurate sensor and it's waterproof, so perfect for the soils. So if the temperature of the soil is very high, or if there is very less water in the plant, then it will turn on a water pump. So this way it can detect the less water, and it can prevent the overwatering of the plants. So now this is the preview of our app. So here, as we can see, this is the Blink app. So all that data which we saw is transmitted to the Blink, and this is running over cellular network. So here we can detect gases like hydrogen, CH3, like butane, carbon monoxide, hydrogen dioxide, ammonia, methane and butane. So and it can also detect this temperature, the humidity and the air pressure. So the air pressure is in Pascal and the humidity and the temperature. And so we can also control the robot. So and this is the data from the nodes. So in the nodes it can give us the soil temperature data, and also the data about the soil moisture. So the soil moisture data is raw, and it can detect the soil temperature data. So we can also manually control the pump, or we can have some other controls. So if the moisture is less or that, then we have the conditions so that it can send an email notification and turn on the water pump. So if there is a fire, the carbon monoxide levels and the and CO2 will increase, and the temperature will also rise. So based on that, we have a condition that if it is more, then can trigger an alarm to your smartphone's notification. So this is how this project works. So it's quite simple, and it can help a lot of Indian farmers, and it is quite economical, and it is very efficient at detecting diseases. So it can detect plant diseases at up to accuracy 94%, and non-diseased plants with an accuracy of 85%. So it's quite good for a single board computer. And all these devices are currently connected with Wi-Fi. So I would plan to use a radio frequency or NRF, or some very long distance Bluetooth, and a cellular shield with a proper waypoint algorithm for the GPS so that it can properly pump the data to the cloud and navigate in the fields automatically. So that's how this project works. Thank you for watching and please subscribe.